Good evening. Every February, we here at Tiger TV and South Plainfield High School honor the contributions and sacrifices of African Americans who have helped shape the United States and the world. Black History Month celebrates the rich cultural heritage, triumphs, and adversities that are an inevitable part of our history. This year's theme, Black Health and Wellness, pays homage to the medical scholars and healthcare providers. This is especially timely as we enter the third year of the COVID-19 pandemic, which has disproportionately affected minority communities. February was chosen primarily because the second week of the month coincides with the birthdays of both Abraham Lincoln and Frederick Douglass. Lincoln was influential in the emancipation of slaves, and Douglass, a former slave, was a prominent leader in the abolitionist movement, which fought to end slavery. Lincoln and Douglass were each born in the second week of February, so it's traditionally a time when African Americans would hold celebrations in honor of the emancipation. Here are a few pieces created by the Tiger TV team to honor the significant people, places, and events that have contributed to our history.
Nora Neale Hurston was an American anthropologist, author, and filmmaker in the 1900s. She is best known for writing and studying African American folklore. She attended Harvard University to get an associate's degree and participated in student government. Her most famous novel is Their Eyes Were Watching God in 1937, which is about a young African American woman's journey. She eventually collaborated with Langston Hughes to make the play Mulebone. Despite this, she never received the financial support she deserved, and couldn't even afford a headstone. Her tombstone remained unmarked from 1960 to 1973, before a young writer placed a marker on Hurston's grave. Hurston used her skill to educate people on the arts and inspire young writers to follow in her footsteps.
Black History Month takes place every year throughout the month of February. Many important people have contributed to the movement, one being Dr. Dorothy Height. Dr. Height was a civil and women's rights activist. As a high school student, Dorothy began her speaking career as an anti-lynching activist, and since then she had broadened her career. She was one of many determined people who helped to organize the march that took place in Washington, D.C. in 1963, and worked alongside Martin Luther King on many campaigns. She also ran the YMCA in Harlem as well as the National Council of African American Women for 20 years. Dr. Dorothy Height died April 20, 2010, and contributed her late years strengthening the African American family.
Singer, songwriter, and actress Diana Ross is a 12-time Grammy nominee and was recognized as one of the most iconic singers of all time with a career that spans for over four decades. Her fame rose because of her vocal group, The Supremes, which became Motown's most successful act during the 1960s and one of the world's best-selling girl groups of all time. She received a Grammy Award for her lifetime achievement in 2012 and the Presidential Medal of Freedom in 2016. In 1993, the Guinness Book of World Records pronounced her the most successful female artist ever, not only because of her solo work, but because of her role as lead singer of The Supremes. In 1988, Ross was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as a member of the Supremes alongside Florence Ballard and Mary Wilson. She is a recipient of the Kennedy Center Honors in 2007 and the Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award in 2012. These achievements make her an amazing role model to many young and aspiring artists.
I said I could not move because history had me glued to the seat.
Claudette Colvin has played a huge part in advancing civil rights in her city. Colvin was born on September 5, 1939, in Montgomery, Alabama. She grew up in the poorer neighborhood of Montgomery. She studied hard in school and managed to earn all A's in her classes. On March 2, 1955, she was riding the bus when the bus driver asked her to give up her seat for a white passenger.
And I said, I paid my fare and it's my constitutional rights. And they put me in the squad car and they handcuffed me through the window.
Eventually, Colvin was able to make a difference and inspire other civil rights activists to try and spark change in the world.